Hey everybody, and a warm welcome to a new story. Today's story is called M Wants to Steal My Birthday Cake. My mother terrifies her kid and her into backing of. From the Entitled Parents subreddit. I hope you like it and will enjoy the time. If you like my content and this kind of videos, please leave a comment and subscribe to my channel. As always, this story is told from the OP's point of view. Enjoy it. So I've recently encountered an entitled mother at Waitrose in UK. This story features me only as a partial spectator and my mum as the victim of the M, or M the victim of my mother in all honestly. Happened over a week ago, but only now getting the time to write it. For some context, all of you here in UK know that this is a fairly pricey grocery store aimed at middle upper class. Me and my parents rarely go in it, unless we have a good coupon or want cakes, as their bakery is utterly delicious and not as pricey as everything else. This happened about a week ago, and recently I had my 21st birthday and my parents have decided to order me a whole rainbow cake as my birthday cake as a treat, which only cost about £20, 16 bucks. This cake is always at a high demand as it is one of their best sellers, meaning that the only way you are likely to get one full is if you order it online or come really early to the store. You simply place an order and a cake is reserved for you at a date, where you then can pick it up and pay at the store. Simple enough, right? I know it comes off as a little childish, but the cake is delicious and I love colors, so heck with it. So it was the day before my birthday, and my parents had driven to town and I came along for the free ride, and at the end of the day, about 5 p.m, we headed towards the shop to pick up the cake. By the time we had gotten into the shop and into the little bakery section, we did not see many people around waiting to be served, but we did see a lot of people who had stopped dead in their tracks to watch a lady. I want to say she had the "I want to speak to your manager" hair, but she didn't really. She looked like the most common middle-aged blonde with no identifiable taste in clothes, tacky and straight up ugly. The most memorable thing was most likely her massive nails and the freaking infinite amount of rings on her fingers, tacky, fake rings to match her ugly accent, that she waved as she yelled at the employee behind a counter. With her, she had a girl who didn't look over 10 or 12, I can't really tell kids' ages anymore in modern times. I heard an audible sigh from my own mother, who then rolled her eyes. It was a busy day. As we got closer, this is the conversation I could make out. "M, what do you mean you don't have rainbow cakes?" she yelled. "Employee, I'm sorry ma'am, we are all out for today. We sold our last daily patch at 2 p.m. "M, well go check again you idiot. I need IT for my daughter's birthday. It is ASPECIAL," she elongated words, "occasion." As if talking to someone challenged. The child I did not want to pass judgment on until I saw and heard this, the little girl started whining and banging on the counter. It was very tall so she couldn't reach anything, so instead banged on the lower half of it, kicking it and crying. "Ek, mommy you promised, I want it, I want it. I was my unicorn." She then emitted this ugly and high-pitched screech that made my back shiver. "Employee, ma'am, please calm down, there is nothing I can do for you." "M, well then make one, that's what you are here for, aren't you? You lazy cow. This country is going to shit cuss fucking lazy immigrants like you, get fucking jobs and do nothing useful." She berated the woman. I'm not even sure why, the woman at the counter was English and spoke it perfectly, heck better than me. "Employee, ma'am, you need to calm down." "M, don't tell me what to do, you dirty immigrant. I'm here to spend money. Go make a new one and make use of yourself. I need it today and no later. Where else do you think I'm going to get a cake for my little princess? By now the EK was thrashing everything about and dropping this and items on the food and picked them out of her mother's basket and chucking them about in protest. Employee, ma'am, I am sorry, but we are unable to start baking anything at this hour, and even if I could, I do not have the time. The M continued staring at the employee as if she was an alien, speaking in another language. My mom and me are not pleasant people when we are tired. My mother simply shoves past the woman and approaches the counter. Pushing the woman aside, making her gasp, my stepfather standing between my mother and her. Mom, hello, she said with a smile as the employee wasn't doing anything wrong. I knew my parents were worried that they may have sold the reserved cake, but my mom decided to ask anyway. Mom, excuse me, I heard you said you ran out, but we reserved a cake and if you still have it, we'd love to pick it up. Employee smiled and said, oh miss. My mother noted as the M stared at the interaction, she tried to yell and ask my mom to move, but she simply ignored her like a bad small in a large room. The employee proceeds to open a second cabinet and take out a box, open it and show a full rainbow cake. M, wait, you said you didn't have any, you ... liar. Employee, yes ma'am, we have no available cakes, this was reserved to be picked up at 5 p.m. today. M looks at my mother and tells her with an angry look, listen here, I was here first. This is my daughter's cake. Give it to me. My little darling has her birthday in 2 days, mom. Well, this one is for my daughter's birthday tomorrow, you should have ordered it like I did. The M looked at me with a disguised look, you are an adult, what the fuck is wrong with you? You are too old for a cake. Me, and you are too old and ugly to throw a tantrum? M, excuse me? Me, you heard me, or are you deaf as well as brain challenged? You know that iron look and that move less turn of the neck, where the body stands in one directly like a rock and only the head moves. My mother turned to her and calmly asked in a booming but calm voice. Completely ignoring this conversation. Mom, did you order one online? M, no, but mom, did you wait here? M, wah, but you're. Mom, I'll take that as an uneducated no. I'm not giving you shit and your spoiled brat can suck it. Learn how to shut you brat's mouth too. M, do not tell ME how to pair. The kid was now crying and screeching. My mother turns to the whining kid and yells at her, in a booming voice that shook the room. Shut up you, the kid visibly spooks and turns dead silent, all color drained out of its face. Looking at her with the most terrified look in her eyes, not even crying. Only stared at her like a deer in headlights. My mother turned back to the employee and said with a smile, will that be £20? She nodded her head in a yes and thanked her for the payment and ordering the cake online. The entitled mother then suddenly tried to push past mine and grab the cake on the counter. My father's shoulder rose out of reflex to get in the way, but luckily during the conversation and shuffled closer, close enough to harshly step forward towards the gap in between, right onto the M's foot, making her yelp and looked down onto her broken front heel. M, you fat ... she yelled me, I smiled and said, of, my bad. Shouldn't have gotten in the way. M, you stepped on me, I sure did. I replied with a smile, and moved away as my mother started walking away. The woman tried to chase after us, but couldn't as she had a small limp and her child just teared up a little. Honestly, maybe that will teach her a little more humility and an appropriate way to be upset rather than throwing a tantrum. My mother would have crucified me if I ever pulled something like that as a kid. I want to say I hope that kid learned a lesson and doesn't grow up to be like that, but I highly doubt it. At least I got my cake and had a great birthday and now have a fun story to tell. What do you think about this story? Tell me your thought in the comments. If you liked the story and the content, please leave a like, subscribe and share this video. Also have a look into my playlist for more entertaining stories.